Hello and welcome to the demonstration of Dynavista CAA application for system CATIA V5. My name is Jakob Schmeder and I work for DYTRON company, who is the sole distributor for this solution within the European region. Just a few words off the start about DYTRON. We are a business consulting company dealing with Dassault Systems products. One of the products is CATIA, and today I would like to guide you through one of the existing custom applications to CATIA, namely Dynavista CAA. The presentation aims to familiarize you with the solution and to introduce key functionalities and key usage benefits to you. Without further ado, let's dive into it. Here we see the basic structure composition in modules that together make one of the Dynavista packages, called the Die Layout Design Package. It consists of three modules: Formability Fillet, Formability Shaper, and Die Face Design. The software is scalable, so any combination of these modules is possible, even though the full package is the most cost effective than the separate modules or their combinations. A few words about suitability of using individual modules. Now, only briefly though, the entire superstructure is particularly suited for tool shops as a whole, but the Formability Fillet is actually suitable for any design development phases, not only tools. Wherever the user is confronted with complex rounding, for example, typical uses are in the areas of product development, mold making, prototypes, or just pressing tools. The Formability Shaper and Die Face Design are then typically used for the purpose of the tool room in comprehensive design of the die tools. Let's now take a closer look at the first of the modules from the Die Layout Design Package, and one which is the most commonly used one, the Formability Fillet. If you've come to a conclusion that you could do better at any time during your work with CATIA and the formation of complicated roundings and technological radii, you're right to think so. Developers of this extraordinary application have been guided by the many years of experience and needs of designers and toolmakers, and built up a number of features that are custom and tailored to them. You don't have to worry that Dynavista functions are separated. On the contrary, they are integrated into native CATIA system and its tree algorithms, so you can use both solutions simultaneously. If you get with CATIA to a situation where the rounding function is just not enough, in most cases you need an aid by preparing wireframe and surface geometry, which is usually very tedious. And time savings is the crucial factor in working with this solution. There's a huge contribution from Dynavista. It has functions that CATIA doesn't possess, so you don't have to create so many auxiliary and preparatory geometries. In addition, its algorithms are such that areas do not show high curvature locations in complicated situations. Like, we all know a situation where, for instance, you cannot offset geometry, and many others. A note warning here, a necessary condition for using Dynavista Formability Fillet module is that you must have a license for generative shape design in CATIA. This application is on the market for over 15 years now, and it is true some features have gradually begun to appear in CATIA itself. Let's take a look at a few of the benefits of using Formability Fillet. First point is that Dynavista has incomparably more rounding capabilities, making the usage of CATIA V5 much more efficient. The term fill already exists in CATIA and started its appearance in release R24. But the third point, the variable radius, even for fillet between surfaces, still not in CATIA as such. Another benefit is that a constant variable chord in CATIA, we only have the constant option. It is also related to the approach of the work, but the fillets on top of the other fillets and DYTRON features is another possibility. CATIA does not have the ability to connect the edges of other fillets, and transition surfaces and converging really is, in CATIA, a much longer and more complex process. CATIA doesn't have an option to repair poor quality surfaces and quickly fix them. Dynavista has an option which is called fairing. And the analysis in CATIA is otherwise mostly through functions and, again, much more complex. But in Dynavista we have a distance analysis by a spectral map as an option. This slide simply serves for a quick overview and breakdown of functional areas. The full portfolio of features is dealt with in detail at the eventual trainings, but I will now introduce you to the most common tools with the help of prepared materials in the form of practical examples. The introduced features will include rounding, junction trim, connect feature, gradation surface, and fillet fairing to repair the poor surfaces mentioned before. Here we see a comparison of solutions to little more complex geometric situations for a better idea of time savings as the key benefit. Gradually, the individual situations on different complexity and comparison are compared as regards to the execution speed and the quality of resulting geometry. Specifically, in CATIA V5, now relatively outdated, however, to compare the non-parametric type of work it is included here. Compared to the pure CATIA V5 solution and V5 together with Dynavista. So for CATIA V4, every change is necessary to be remade as a whole. Working with a clean solution of CATIA V5 is now the standard for most of the users, and you know yourselves that some roundings are way more time consuming, sometimes even impossible to make. CATIA V5 together with Dynavista though do the work in a matter of seconds due to the custom made features. We are able to see some of these situations on the presentations and practical examples. Now, just shortly, let's take a look at the evaluation of the application by its users. Here we have a testimony of one of the testers at Forkim, Boleslav. You have 3 points. The first one simply states that it is a powerful tool for the construction of sheet metal and plastic parts in general. Second point is connected to the fact that only a few geometry auxiliaries are needed for the necessary creation. And also a great deal of options and settings are included necessary for the features we want to make. For the time we have been dealing with this application, together with its active users and other companies, we tried to outline the most important benefits that we have summarized here in a few points. So you can see yourself what experience with this product these customers have and where they see the key benefits of using it. So here we see a model of Thor. The work of formability fillet. First, let's take a look at the function of rounding. Very typical feature. So, just going to create on an edge a radius, selecting the length, the radius, seeing the preview functionality. Now, on the propagation, if we want to move further, depending on the support and its geometry, we can set the tolerance and high, as you can see, above 2 degrees. Once we do that, the support will propagate further and we can make an edge as a whole. Now we have to take into consideration the angle of support as well, so again rising the tolerance up to above 2.6 degrees, we can create a simple fillet on the whole edge. Now, what you can set is also the limiting points for the start and end position. In this case, if you want to make the radius shorter, just to set an example, we can do that. Now, let's create a second rounding, a second fillet on the other edge, just right next to it. Small radius, we don't really need to set the propagation here as the curve looks much better. In this second case, start and end position possibly as well, not going for it. Now, once we have these two fillets, we decided we want to sort of find an intersection based on the geometry here, and we can do that with a junction trim, as you can see. So the junction trim finds an intersection between multiple fillets and creates a split. So we have a common edge on one side. In this case, of course, we can choose either side of either of the fillets. Now, once we do that and want to connect it to another geometry, in this case the common edge on one side from the junction trim, and let's set just the point on the other side. Now, you have to set a support as well, which is the solid on which we're working, and simply confirming it, making new connection or connection surface features, you can see. Now, if we want to embed this with the solid, we do that with just a few clicks. Again, you can see very quick solution, a feedback from what we can see as the end. Now, in this second case, we already have a few inputs. You can see a few rounding functionalities. We're going to try and connect these roundings together. Now, in pure CATIA V5, this would be a little bit longer process. In this case, we can take the gradation feature, take 1, 2, 3 edges of the inputs, say the support, and connect it in a very simple and effective way, creating the gradation feature. I'm going to do that afterwards, probably once more, but before that, I'm going to find again the common intersection as in the previous example with the functionality junction trim, and create a new split of two inputs. Now, in this corner, again, you can imagine that in CATIA V5 this would take you a little while. Now, what we do here is the same thing as before, so just a few more inputs in this case. Taking the curves or the edges of the input roundings, or possibly the junction trim, independently and together with the support, which is the join in this case, create a new gradation surface, a smooth fillet. Once we've done this work, we can simply take the embedding functionality again, connect it to the support, which is the join. The gradation surface is our result. So we have the embedding in the end. Again, tensions is fine. A clean solution. Now let's take a look at another model here, another design. So we were talking about repairing faces. Dynavista can do that, unlike in clean CATIA V5. So if you look at this area, you can see a whole discrepancy on the fillets right here. So not really a smooth topology, but we can do a functionality of fillet fairing. Choose the input areas or the input edges together with the fillets, and what we're doing right now is setting the range. So we're finding the borders in which we're going to create a new fillet and repair what's inside. So from all three inputs we set the range, and now simply confirming, as you can see, very quick solution again and a clean one. So comparing to the previous result, we have the smooth geometry once more. Let's take a look at another area right next to it. So taking the fillet fairing functionality, choosing the input fillet surfaces. In some cases we need to choose the support as well. Definitely useful to see and choose the range of fairing. That's what we're doing again right now. Angle of smoothness, default, remaking the geometry, setting it to a smooth result. Easy and quick repairing of geometry with Formability Fillet. So we have the same model as before, but right now I'd like to talk a little bit about the philosophy in which you're making the features in Dynavista in comparison to CATIA V5. What you can see here is some sort of a solution which you would do in CATIA V5. You can see there's quite a lot of features to make, of course with the aid of surface and wireframe geometry, in which you want to create the radius you can see on this surface. Now, what we're going to do is to create this kind of fillet, but in Dynavista. In CATIA, you would do the fillets on each other. In Dynavista, you do everything in preparation before embedding it to your whole model. So the only thing which we're going to need there is the line you can see. We're going to the workbench of Formability Fillet. We're going to start with simple rounding functions. So choosing the input edge, choosing the radius, simply defining, if necessary, the start end position, not in this case. So you can see we're making some sort of a preparation geometry at this moment. Going to create another radius on the other edge. And we're going to create a junction trim to see the mutual intersection as another input for the next step. So right now creating the junction trim, correct sides. That was a mistake made, so I have to do the other side in reverse. Having the input ready. Right now going to create the connection surface feature. So something we already see. Two elements on one side. And we do have the curve on the other one. What we can't forget in this case is to choose the support, which is the solid, and we create a join together, so we have one output feature, which is the connection surface. It does not matter in this case that the fillets are a bit overlapping with the support. Of course, this embedding function, you don't have to do it from a surface point of view. You can do the solid one as we're doing right now, so having to be in a body instead of a geometrical set, and choose the embedding function. And you can see we already have a solid result. Now, there were even a few mistakes made, but despite that, it was very quick.